Hello students, in this video we will solve the problems which are based on rationalization of denominator. Let us consider one question, that is 3 upon 5 minus root 3 plus 2 upon 5 plus root 3. You have to simplify this expression. Now you can see that denominator of these expressions are not free from under root. Hence, we apply rationalization technique for solving these kinds of problems. So, for by applying rationalization technique, we multiply the denominator and numerator by rationalizing factor in each term. That is, for this term, the rationalizing factor is 5 plus root 3. We will multiply 5 plus root 3 in numerator and denominator, and for this term it is 5 minus root 3, so we will multiply 5 minus root 3 in this term. But there is other way to solve this problem easily. You can see denominators are only different from sign. The terms are same, only different from sign. For these kinds of expression, we generally take the LCM of denominator. So, LCM of denominator is 5 minus root 3 and 5 plus root 3 into 5 plus root 3. So, numerator becomes 3 into 5 plus root 3 plus 2 into 5 minus root 3. After taking LCM, numerator becomes 3 into 5 plus root 3 plus 2 into 5 minus root 3. Now simple, just like we are solving the algebraic expression, we will simply multiply 3 in the bracket. So multiplying 3 in the bracket, we get 3 into 5 is 15 and plus 3 root 3, and again applying the same process, 2 5s are 10 and minus 2 root 3. Upon in the denominator, you can see this is a minus b into a plus b, hence the denominator becomes a square minus b square. So 5 square minus root 3 is square. Now collecting in numerator, collecting the like terms, so 15 and 10 are rational. 15 plus 10 becomes 25, and 3 root 3 minus 2 root 3, root part decides that whether the irrational numbers are like irrational numbers or dislike irrational numbers. So since root 3 root 3 are same, hence these are like irrational numbers which can be added and which can be subtracted. So denominator transforms into 25 minus 3. Now numerator becomes 25 plus, you can take out under root 3 common also. So inside the bracket it becomes 3 minus 2, 25 minus 3 becomes 22 in the denominator. And finally 25 plus 3 minus 2 is 1, 1 root 3 is 3 upon 22 is the required answer for this expression. Now let us solve the second equation. Simplify under root 5 minus 2 upon under root 5 plus 2 minus under root 5 plus 2 upon under root 5 minus 2. First of all, you enclose the given terms in bracket. Now again, since denominator is not free from under root, we will apply rationalizing technique, rationalization of each term. So in numerator and denominator we will multiply rationalizing factor in each term, but in this case you can see the denominators are same, only the difference of sign is there. Here plus is there and here minus is there. Hence it is easy or it is convenient to take LCM in this case. So root 5 plus 2 into root 5 minus 2 is the LCM in this case, and the denominator becomes root 5 minus 2 into root 5 minus 2 when divided by root 5 denominator. When you divide after taking the LCM, the leftover expression is root 5 minus 2. Hence root 5 minus 2 into root 5 minus 2. And in the second term, you will get root 5 plus root 2 into root 5 plus 2. Now be careful while solving these kinds of expressions. Now the numerator, you see this is a minus b into a minus b. Hence it is a minus b whole square. So root 5 minus 2 whole square minus this is a plus b into a plus b. So this is a plus b whole square upon, you can see in denominator, a plus b into a minus b, which transforms into a square minus b square. Now in numerator you can apply a square minus b square also, or you can expand the expression by the formula a minus b whole square and a plus b whole square. Let us apply a minus b whole square in this expression. So it becomes under root 5 minus 2 whole square, that is a minus b whole square is a square plus b square minus 2 into a into b. Now here minus sign is there, remember that to apply the bracket before expansion. So again it will be root 5 whole square plus 2 square and plus 2 into 2 root 5 and enclose the term in bracket, and denominator becomes 5 minus 4. Next step, 5 root 5 square is 5, 2 square is 4, and 2 into 2 is 4 root 5. Minus, enclose the bracket, root 5 is 5 plus 4 and plus 4 root 5 upon 1. Denominator transforms into 1. Next step, 5 plus 4 is 9 minus 4 root 5. And here when you open the bracket with minus sign, all the sign inside the bracket of the terms get reversed. Now see, 5 plus 4 is plus 9. When you open the bracket with minus sign, it becomes minus sign. Now plus 4 root 5 becomes minus 4 root 5. And denominator is 1. So in the next step, there is no need to write. So in plus 9 minus 9 gets cancelled out. You have leftover terms as minus 4 root 5 and minus 4 root 5. And now directly you can add, because like these are like irrational numbers, root 5 and root 5. So, or in this way also you can do, taking out root 5 common. So, minus 4 and minus 4 becomes minus 8 root 5 is the required answer. Now, let us move on to the third question. And third question is, you have to prove 1 upon 3 minus root 8 minus 1 upon root 8 minus root 7 plus 1 upon root 7 minus root 6 minus 1 upon root 6 minus root 5 plus 1 upon root 5 minus 2 is equal to 5. So let us take the LHS. For solving this, we will take LHS, and LHS is 3 minus root 8 minus 1 upon root 8 minus root 7. Remember to enclose each terms in bracket. Now 1 upon root 7 minus root 6 minus 1 upon root 6 minus root 5 plus 1 upon root 5 minus 2. Now since we will apply rationalization of denominator. So for the first term, rationalizing factor is 3 plus root 8 and numerator is 1. Hence, numerator becomes 3 plus root 8. And in denominator, directly also you can do 3 minus root 8 into 3 plus root 8 becomes 3 square minus root 8 square. Moving to the next expression. So, root 8 minus plus root 7 is the rationalizing factor. So, numerator becomes root 8 plus root 7 and denominator becomes root 8 square minus root 7 square. Similarly, for the third term, root 7 plus root 6 is the rationalizing factor and denominator becomes root 7 square minus root 6 square. For the next expression, root 6 plus root 5 is the rationalizing factor. Denominator becomes root 6 square minus root 5 square. For the last term, rationalizing factor is 5 plus 2 and denominator becomes root 5 square and minus 2 square. Now, solving the first term, you will get 3 plus root 8. In denominator, 3 square is 9, root 8 is 8. So, you'll get 1. For the next, remember to enclose the terms in bracket whenever there is minus sign. Denominator becomes 1. Then, root 7 plus root 6, denominator becomes 1. For plus sign, it is not necessary to enclose the terms in bracket. But for minus sign, it is very much necessary to enclose the terms in bracket. Denominator becomes 1. And for the last term, root 5 plus 2 upon 1. Now, simplifying the numerator, we will get 3 plus root 8. Now minus root 8 minus root 7. Whenever you open the bracket with minus sign, then the sign becomes reverse for each term. So you can see root 8 was plus. Here it becomes root minus root 8 and plus root 7 becomes minus root 7. By plus sign, there is no effect in the terms of bracket. Again, with minus sign, we are opening the bracket. So, the sign get reversed for each term. Now, let us see this root 5 and root 7 are same. Root 6 and root minus root 6 are same. Plus root 7 minus root 7 and plus root 8 minus root 8 are same. The leftover term is 3 here and the leftover term is plus 2 here. So, you will get 3 plus 2 is equal to 5, which is equal to RHS, hence proved. So, you have questions in which LHS was equal to root 5 and we have proved from LHS to RHS equal to 5. Hence is the required answer. Now, let us simplify another question which is based on rationalization. Again, we have the expression. So, enclose each terms in bracket first. In bracket first. And rationalize each term. So, multiplying rationalizing factor. Rationalizing factor for first term is under root 2 minus under root 3 upon under root 2 plus under root 3.